Okay. We're going to have Colonel Sweden told me to attack, and I couldn't talk to him over the infantry would not be with me. I'd be without infantry going in.
Okay.
And it was already getting dark. And so I was hedging around, and Colonel Sweden said, I'm going to commit that air, the reserve platoon, so this platoon, four tanks from eight company come down by, and that way we went by, and got down in the town. There was some farms for a while, and there was nothing.
Mm-hmm.
And Sweden told me to get him out, get him back out. Well, their radios and mine weren't synced together.
Uh-huh.
I could hear him, but he could not hear me.
Okay.
So I kept it, and finally I said, well, I got to go. So I took the platoon myself and went down into Casano. And it was dark.
Uh-huh.
And I come up behind the tanks that had been there. They were abandoned.
Okay.
And then the big red ball of the fire were going past me. So I went back and got in the tank and backed out. Well, when they were doing it, they were firing in the dark, too.
Uh-huh.
But they knocked the second story of a house onto the back of a tank. I had about maybe
a couple
tons of shit,
debris.
And got out. The guy was behind me. First thing, a couple months later, said how happy he was to see me backing out. He was in the tank right behind mine. He didn't want to.
So,
yeah.
Did you go in with those tanks, or did you have, those were the abandoned tanks that you started taking?
As soon as I got to those abandoned tanks, that was the first, then there was the only thing to do was back out.
Okay.
And we backed out, you had to back all the way because you couldn't turn around.
Okay.
And until we got back to the quarry.
Huh.
Anyway, let's see. Well, that was that day. The next afternoon, about noon,
my
Major Dalvin, who was the exec officer of the battalion, was leading the attack, and he had one company from the 760 tank train had been attached to it,
mm-hmm.
and he was in the second tank. But his tank got knocked out. I'm in the creek bed, right below. It's right next, but the road in the bank adjoins.
Uh-huh.
Anyway, when that happened, my Dalvin took and jumped from his tank, which was burning in already, onto mine, and I gave him my radio.
Uh-huh.
And he conducted the attack from there, see?
Okay.
And at that time, there was a lull for a while, and finally Dalvin, Sweeney is up one side of the hill. He says, Dalvin, what's holding you up? And Dalvin was from Georgia.
Uh-huh.
He had dimples.
Uh-huh.
He was a good-looking guy.
Uh-huh.
And he looks around like this, you know, he says, hey,